Hey learners, welcome to Learn to Empower. Before we start into the topic, I want to ask you a question. Think about it. Do you know which ministry or agency constructs road in the national, state, village and border areas? Do you know how many checks and clearances it has to undergo? Why do roads are dug up so frequently in the name of pipelines, fiber optic cables, repairs, etc.? Don't they have an integrated approach? With the increasing delay in the completion of projects, what were we are getting? Is there any way out from this? Yes, PM Gat Shakti National Master Plan can be the way out. On October 13th, Prime Minister has launched this program, as he mentioned in his Independence Day speech of 2020-21. The stated objective is that this will enable multiple ministries and state governments to collaborate on the development and implementation of infrastructure projects. So, this program aims to increase the speed, which is nothing but gati, and the power, which is shakti, of projects by bringing together all relevant departments on single platform. When we compare with the existing system, one of the most significant bottlenecks in the existing system is the multiplicity of permissions and delays in the clearance. This program would provide geo-mapping and real-time data in a centralized platform to ensure that important ministries and states have visibility into major projects in the planning stages, particularly those with a multi-sector and multi-regional reach. Some of the multi-sector and multi-regional projects are Bharatmala, Sagarmala, inland waterways, dry or land ports, Udan, and other infrastructure plans of various ministries and state governments. It also includes economic zones such as textile clusters, pharmaceutical clusters, defense corridors, electronic parks, industrial corridors, fishery clusters, and agro zones would be covered to bolster economic connectivity and increase the competitiveness of Indian firms. This program also used the technology, including the spatial planning tool based on ISRO Imaginary. So, with the end in multiple effects, it will result in faster project implementation and cost containment. This program mainly focuses on six pillars. One is a comprehensiveness, which will consolidate all the existing and planned initiatives across many ministries and departments through a single centralized platform. The second one is a prioritization through cross-sectoral interactions where several departments will be able to prioritize their initiatives. The third is optimization, that is, after identifying the essential gaps, it will aid various ministries in preparing for projects. For example, when it comes to the transporting items from one location to another, the plan will assist in determining the most efficient route in terms of time and cost. The next one is the coordination of individual ministries and departments, which frequently operate in isolation. Through this program, it will assist in holistically synchronizing the activities of each department as well as the various tiers of governance by ensuring that work is coordinated between them. The next is analytical, where the plan will centralize all data through use of GIS-based spatial planning and analytical tools with a 200 plus level, providing the executing agencies with more visibility. The last and final pillar is dynamic, that is, through GIS platform, all the ministries and departments will now be able to visualize, review and monitor the progress of cross-sectoral projects. This effort will involve 16 central ministries, including railways, roads, highways, petroleum and gas, power, telecom, shipping, etc. In this, railway are said to handle some 1600 million tons of freight by 2024-25. According to the plan, the country's gas pipeline network will double almost 34,500 kilometers by 2024-25. By 2024-25, the overall transmission network is expected to reach 4.52 lakh circuits. the civil aviation, the goal is to double the current aviation footprint to 220 airports. In shipping, the National Master Plan states that the goal is to increase total cargo handling capacity at the ports some to 2000 metric tons by 2024-25. While under the road initiative, the target is to have some 2 lakh kilometers of national highways. By 2024-25, the plan envisions 11 industrial corridors, including a military industry. With 11 industrial corridors and 2 defense corridors, this strategy would significantly boost our MSME sector by enabling it to participate in our economic rapid expansion. This program will not only provide essential services to the most remote corners of our country, but will also greatly increase the economic potential for the inclusive growth. Among this, the expected benefits would be to fill the gaps between macroeconomic and microeconomic implementation. It will increase the coordination, it will have a last mile connectivity, movements of goods and services will be smoothened, the movements of people will also be in streamline. It also increases the employment, it will cut down the logistic cost and overall budget, will improve the supply chain, and the prices will be made competitive. This will boost our exports, it also increases our ease of living as well as ease of doing business. Right, with this, we'll come to the end to this video. So, coming to next video, we will have much more analysis with some other topic. Till then, take care. Thank you.